Good evening, YouTube. I'm going to show you how to clean some tools. Occasionally you find that you've got some tools that are a little bit dirty, like this one. It's getting pretty bad, and you want to brighten them up. Well, the simple way to do that is take a rag, any old rag will do, old pair of pants, something like that. Get some WD-40, spray it on the rag, and then gently wipe your tool. It'll make it much nicer. Much cleaner, and even on the scrummy bits, with a bit of work, it'll come up nice. Okay, so you can hopefully see that's a little bit cleaner and shinier. Now there are some tougher bits on this, and occasionally you'll get some tools that are a bit more mucky, a bit more rust on them. And for that, you can use malt vinegar to soak the tool in. So, if your tools look like this, or like a lot of my other tools, like this, the light, gentle touch will not work. So this was a box of tools that I forgot was in the garden, and it got rained on, and left in the garden. And now, I'm trying quite hard, and those won't work. That, surprisingly, this does work, kind of. I can't change which angle it goes and things. And, you know, things are a bit grimy, stuff like that. So, first off, I'm going to give it a quick wash with some soap water. And then I'm going to put it in the malt vinegar. Show you the results. So the procedure for the first step is quite simple. Get the tool. Bucket of warm soapy water. Warm because you don't like having cold hands. Just rushing it around is not going to do anything. So you get a scrubbing brush, one that you've already ruined by trying to clean your hand when you've had a lot of oil or tar on it. It's perfect for this, and you give it a scrub. It's not easy to do one-handed, but even with one hand, you see, it just takes the surface dirt off. Compare it to the other side, fairly filthy. Oops. It's not perfect, but the purpose of this step is just to get the loose stuff off so that when you put it in the vinegar there's less rust in there for the vinegar to attack that isn't part of the tool. Because what I really want is all the vinegar to work on the rust on the tool. So I've got my tray full of parts that I'm going to submerge, and I've tried to get some similar ones. I'm going to try wrapping and just dampening. So I've got some moving pliers, both of those pliers are seized. I've got a couple of silvery wrenches, they're nice looking, really rusty cold chisel there, and then a really rusty screwdriver here. Probably about the same since taking it at the bottom of my toolbox. I found this cool little thing that I'd completely forgotten was in there. I'm not even sure I knew it was in there. It's like a little set of graded wrenches, which is completely seized and ruined, so hopefully some magic will happen. I've got a lot of tools, so I'll see which method works best and then carry on. And I'm going to be throwing that away because it's leaked, broken, the handle's off it and everything else. But you can see there was a lot of grot on there. But they cleaned up pretty well just with a bit of scrubbing. And as a bonus, even my scrubbing brush has cleaned up and lost a lot of the stuff that's on it. So just a bit of dish soap, some warm water and some scrubbing, and gets the tar off that too. Right, so here's the before. I'll check back in a couple of hours. One last thing, I'm just going to add the vinegar, so I'll just try and dampen these ones, don't use a ton of it, so everything's just wrapped up nice and close. And it's just that the paper towel will get soaked, keep it all against the surface. That's looking, oh, it's too much, but there we go, pretty good to me. And these just simply submerge. Now I'm cheating. I haven't bought new vinegar. I've got an old jar of pickling vinegar that I'm going to top it up with as well. I'll show you how it gets on in a bit.
Good morning. I did check in on this stuff after a couple of hours, and there were a few little marks coming through on this paper, but nothing like now. This is now about 10 hours later because it got late and then left overnight. because those pliers were not moving, nor were the ones in there. I did pick out this and this. It wasn't very heavily. This wasn't very heavily marked, and things like this, very light feels, just came off straight away when I rubbed it with my finger. So hopefully now I've given it longer, that looks like it's all coming off pretty well. So the two options for what to do next are scrub it with a little brush or just give it a wipe down. So I'm going to try and give it a wipe down first, which is maybe difficult one-handed, but usual thing you try when you're videoing with a camera in your hand. That's pretty good. And this wasn't a very badly marked part. There's obviously some worse bits around the end here that possibly need more attention. Maybe they're coming up not too badly. And then I think just to get into the little holes, I'm going to use this old toothbrush. Give me a sec. I shall fetch a few parts out, give them a preliminary clean, and see how they turn out. So I've got this drop which I'll try, and this drop which I'll try. I'll show you what they look like now. Give them both a scrub and then show you the results. Okay, everything's had a scrub. This is how it's turned out. So we've got this bench from before. It's actually come out pretty good. That was the one wrapped in that bit of paper towel. So it's pretty clean. There's still some quite rough bits on it. This is quite raised and rough, if you can see it in profile. But yeah, so it's not perfect, but it's probably much better than it was. And this is the wrench that had been left in the vinegar sort of bath overnight. Again, there's a couple of bits on it that are not really coming up. But they're the really rough raised bits. All the surface stuff wasn't too lumpy, it's coming out pretty well. So it's worked okay. And I've been through the rest of everything and cleaned that up. So we've got these pincers, which look like they're still silver underneath. Those are in paper. It's done a pretty good job of working for the surface. I can't move them. I'm not going to force them. I'm going to try and put some penetrating oil and things on them. Maybe they'll be usable again, maybe they won't. This was my sort of worst bit. This is the cold chisel. It's actually, it doesn't look fantastic, but it has cleaned up pretty well. That was just wrapped in the paper towel again. That paper towel there, which you can see is pretty filthy now. The bar I wrapped in paper towel, that's turned out not too bad. Still a few marks and things, but this was pretty grotty before I forgot it in the rain. And then I had some tiny little things. That's an Allen key that was really scummy I put in there. It's still pretty scummy, but it's almost sort of a usable shape now. That was in the paper towel. And then here's everything that I'd left in the bath, because the bath has got the advantage that you can fit quite a lot in there. So there's another spanner that's come out really well. The thing I quite like about the bath and the vinegar, all the little surface stuff, once you put the brush on it, has gone away. Oops, doesn't matter if it goes back in the vinegar. I've not rinsed these yet. That was the other pair of pliery grippy things. Again, surface colours come back quite nicely. Can't move it still. Yeah, cleaned it up well. Here's the nice big wrench. That's come out quite well. It always had this sort of quite a texture to the surface, but that side looks amazing. I think this is the side that didn't get so much rust or something anyway before, or this happened to be the side that was down in the bath, and I don't know if that actually had any effect on it. I think it's just not so bad a side. But yeah, the ends and everything are nice and clean. My bad piece for in there was this manky screwdriver, which is still a pretty manky screwdriver. It is a potty end, but you probably have some luck getting on there. But I didn't really expect that to come out. That looks pretty far gone. And then some other nice bits that I've put in the bath because I had space. So chrome, this was pretty gnarly, but once it's had a scrub, almost looks like new. That
was once a chromed, but that hasn't worked so well. Again, this really rough stuff just doesn't come out so well in that. I mean, if I bath it for longer, maybe it would, but I think I'm going to have to put like a stiffer brush on it, because I am using only this old toothbrush, just because I wanted to see, you know, how much force you needed to apply to scrub things off. Another chrome fitting turned out pretty well. Looks pretty clean in most places. The brush can get down the little holes and things. Pleased with that. This looks amazing. This was pretty covered in gack and some stuff that I expected not to come out. It's almost, you know, that is almost perfectly clean now. It looked pretty covered before. I've kept this, I've not scrubbed half of this to give you an idea what it looks like before. So this is the unscrubbed side. See all this brown is on there. That's even just from being in the bath, that looks a little bit better. And if we rotate round, this is the side that I've just put the toothbrush across briefly, and you see that's looking almost like new. This black stuff where it was sat on the bottom of a thing, that doesn't clean off so well, but everything else comes up pretty good. And what else have I got? So this was looking similar to the last piece, but again, I've brushed this all off. It's all looking pretty good. And then I had my little tiny magical spanner set. Now the colours come back on the surface of them. You can see the individual parts are starting to show a little bit more, but I think I'm going to leave that in the bath a while longer because it's pretty awful. And then I'm going to try and get the penetrating oil out to get this apart, because it's not much use, but it's kind of cool. Back in the bath with you. And then a UJ that's seized. Well, I didn't expect it to unseize, but it's now looking much cleaner. You know, it's a tool that I might actually look at and think, I'm going to take care of it and treat it with a bit of respect. Whereas these had all got to the point where I was thinking about binning them. I've got a lot more tools to do. I'll post an update once I've been through everything and you can see what these turn out like. This is what I'm working with here. I think most of these actually clean up pretty well. That I'd be surprised if it looked much different afterwards, because it's just an iron bar. What else? I'll be able to spot my plumbing wrench in the pile at the end, so that's what it looks like now. For before. Not too bad, but not great. And yeah, so chuck things in the bucket, give them a few hours each and a light scrub, see how it goes. I might, for some of these worst bits, see if I put an electric wheel on them, but that'll probably be for another day. I forgot one last thing that's very important. After you've had them in this bath, the vinegar's quite acidic. That's how it eats through the rust and things. What you must do to stop it continuing to eat through your part is give it a damn good rinse. So just rinse all the vinegar off and neutralise that acid. Yeah, some people use bicarbonate of soda and things to neutralise the acid, which you can do, but if you just rinse it quite a lot, then you should be washing all the acid away. And then once it's had a good rinse, leave it to dry. And then get your oily rag, a bit of old engine oil, clean engine oil on it, and give it a light wipe over, or WD-40 if you like. WD-40 is quite thin, so I think it tends to evaporate off, but it's better than nothing. So yeah, let it dry, oily rag, store it away somewhere out of the rain. Here's the final result. So there's a few more tools cleaning, but I'm pretty pleased with some of these chrome ones have come up almost perfect. That was a nice surprise. That was a really black bar before. There's a little bit there where it wasn't in the vinegar. After it came out, bright and shiny. Yeah, it's all turned out really rather nice. And once I put a bit of WD-40 on them, these pliers and everything work okay. Alright, we've got the new nice ones. We've gone slightly silvery, and you can actually read some of the writing on them, pattern numbers and things like that, US Armstrong and badge numbers and things, and actually working set of pliers now. Yeah, it's all pretty good. So these sockets and things work out nice and shiny again, and it's all had a wipe down with an oily rag, which I've still got some of the oil in my hand. Because I did notice that when I didn't do that, some of these ones, like this was super shiny before. Of course, it had been out in the air for a few, well, maybe 2 hours or something drying. And it picked up all these marks and things again, so I wiped all the second batch straight away. And these have stayed nice and really bright and shiny. So maybe I'll give that another clean sometime. But it's all pretty good. So there we go. From one horrible grotty toolbox for rust to a new toolbox with some tools.